हाई फ्रेंड, वेलकम टू अवर यूट्यूब चैनल IIBS IAS Academy. दिस इज राकेश सिंह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट IIBS IAS Academy. आई हैव डन माई PGD BRM फ्रॉम मणिपाल यूनिवर्सिटी. सिंस लास्ट 6 ईयर्स आई हैव बीन टीचिंग टू द UPSC aspirant. In this YouTube channel, we will be discussing about the daily current affairs and the topics which are related to UPSC as well as the other competitive exams. Please do subscribe, like and comment on the below section. Hi friends, welcome to IIBS IAS Academy. Today, we'll discuss about one of the hot topic in current affairs, that is GST, Goods and Service Tax. What is GST? GST, it is an indirect tax which we levied on all goods and services. The concept of GST, it is not new in India. History of GST. In the year 2000, Vajpayee government, when Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji was the Prime Minister of India, at that time, he has constituted one committee. Name of the committee was Asim Das Gupta Committee. So that committee was established to prepare the model on GST. Then in the year 2006, when there was a UPA one government, Congress government, at that time the finance minister of Congress government announced in the year 2006 that GST will be implemented in India from 1st April 2010. Then in the year 2011, the GST bill was introduced in parliament, but it was lapsed. Then again in the year 2014, the GST bill was introduced at 122nd Constitutional Amendment Bill, and in the year 2015, Lok Sabha passed that bill. Then again in the year 2016, Rajya Sabha passed that bill, and that bill got the assent of the president. Then that bill become act. Then that act is popularly known as 101 Constitutional Amendment Act, that is GST, Goods and Service Tax. So what are the changes which were brought by the 101 Constitutional Amendment Act in our constitution? What were those amendments? So 101 Constitutional Amendment Act amended Article 249. So according to this Article 249, if there is a national interest at that time, if Rajya Sabha passed resolution with a majority of 2/3 of member present and vote, so at that time parliament will make law in GST. Normal time, GST Council, this is also a constitutional body which makes law and celebrates in GST. But whenever there is a national interest and Rajya Sabha passed resolution, and that resolution has to be passed with 2/3 of majority, at that time, instead of GST Council make law, parliament will make law under GST. So that is an amendment under 101 Constitutional Amendment Act, that is Article 249. Then Article 250 were also amended. So what was that amendment? According to the newly amendment, during national emergency, parliament will make law regarding GST, not GST Council. So that was that amendment under Article 250. Even Article 268 were also amended. So earlier we have exercise duty on medical and toilet preparation. So previously, pre-GST regime, we have exercise duty on medical and toilet preparations. So by amending the Article 268, now we don't have excise duty on medical and toilet preparation. Now medical and toilet preparation comes under GST. Then again Article 268A. So previously, before the introduction of the GST, we have service tax, but at present we don't have service tax. Actually Article 268A, it has deleted from constitution. Earlier Article 268A deals with service tax. At present, after the implementation of GST, वी डोंट हैव सर्विस टैक्स. सो 101 कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट एक्ट इवन रिपील और डिलीटेड आर्टिकल 268. देन अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट आर्टिकल 269 आल्सो अमेंडेड. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द रीसेंट अमेंडेड अंडर आर्टिकल 269 द पार्लियामेंट हैज अ पावर टू मेक लॉ रिलेटेड टू interstate trade and commerce. Then what is the meaning of interstate trade and commerce? Interstate trade and commerce means the trade between one state to another state. Whenever there is a transaction, trade or commerce between one state to another state, at that time parliament will make law, not the state assembly. So that was the amendment done under article 269. So again, by 101 Constitutional Amendment Act, Article 246 added. So what is that Article 246? So according to this newly article, Article 246, now central government as well as the state government, both government has a power to make a law in goods and service taxes. Then apart from that, in intrastate trade, then what is the meaning of intrastate trade? Intrastate trade means trade within the state, not outside the state. Intrastate trade means trade within the state. So whenever we have a transaction of intrastate, on the transaction both central government as well as the state government has a power to impose GST. Central will impose CGST, state will impose SGST whenever we have intrastate transaction or a trade or commerce. Then apart from that, article 246A also says that whenever there is a interstate transaction means a transaction or a trade or commerce between one state to another state. So under interstate transaction, only central government has an exclusive power to make a law under GST. So this is about article 246A. 101 Constitutional Amendment Act also added one article, that is article 269. So article 269 says that central government will levy and collect the tax on interstate trade and commerce or interstate transaction. Okay, so it is the central government who will levy as well as collect the tax, not the state government. After collecting the tax, central government will share the part of this tax with state government on the recommendation of GST Council. So that is article 269A. Then apart from that, article 269A also says that whatever the proceedings of GST under IGST or whatever the proceedings of GST on interstate, so that will be not be a part of consolidated fund of India. That means at central level we have one fund that is called consolidated fund of India. So whatever the tax which were levied and collected by the central government, that will be a part of consolidated fund of India. But the tax which were levied and collected by central government on interstate trade or commerce or transaction, that tax shall not be a part of consolidated fund of India. 101 Constitutional Amendment Act also inserted one more article, that is article 279. So according to this article 279, the President of India shall establish one council, that is GST Council. Remember friends, GST Council, it is a constitutional body. Then what is meant by constitutional body? A constitutional body is those body which were formed based upon the provision in constitution. For example, we have Election Commission, we have Finance Commission, we have National Commission for SC, we have National Commission for ST. So those are constitutional body which are formed under the provision of constitution. So in the same way, GST Council is also a constitutional body which were formed under the provisions of article 279A. So what is this body. What is the composition of this body? This body contains both member from union government or central government as well as the state government. From central government side, we have two member, union finance minister as the chairman of this council. Whoever the person become the central finance minister or union's finance minister will be the chairman of this GST council. Then apart from that, union minister of state, union minister of state, who is there in charge of revenue or finance? The union finance minister, who is in charge of revenue or finance, also a member of this GST council. So from center side, we have two member, union finance minister and union minister of state, who is in charge of revenue as well as the finance. Then apart from that, from state side, state government will nominate a member. State government will nominate a member, and that member must be a state government minister. State government minister. So from state side, either that member is a finance minister or a taxation minister or any other minister which were nominated by the state government. That means from state government side, it is not compulsory that the member must be a finance minister or a taxation minister. The member might be any member which will be nominated by that state government. So from state government, we have one member from each state. So this is the composition of GST council. Okay. So whenever chairman is not available, at that time vice chairman will preside the GST council meeting. Then who is vice chairman of this GST council? This members from state government, this members from state government will elect one vice chairman from the member among themselves for a period of 1 year. So that person will act as a chairman or preside the meeting of GST council whenever chairman of GST council was not available. Then each and every decision in GST council will be taken based upon the voting power. So whenever there is a decision on something is there which has to be finalized, so that thing will be taken based upon voting power. So generally the decision making voting power, it is 3/4 of the majority. 3/4 of majority. Under this 3/4 of majority, union government has separate weightage and state government has separate weightage. So the weightage of union government under the decision making in GST council is 1/3. 1/3 is the voting power weightage of central government in GST council, and 2/3 is the voting power weightage of state government in GST council. And function of GST council. So what are the function of GST council? What GST council will do? Okay, it is the GST council which we give recommendation to the central government, state government and local bodies regarding which goods taxes, okay, which taxes or which cess or which levy that can be subsumed under the GST. So that is the one of the major function of GST council. In simple language, what are the taxes, cess or surcharge which were levied by the central government, state government or a local self government, local bodies. We have municipals and panchayat raj institutions, those are a part of local bodies. So those local bodies, state government as well as the central government, they levied law, they levied tax. So which tax, which cess and which surcharges should be a part of GST, that will be decided by this GST council. And second, the goods and services which are exempted from the GST tax, that will also determine by this GST council. And apart from that, this GST council also decide the model of GST, how to levy the GST, how to collect the GST. Okay, what are the principle of levying of GST tax? So all these things will be determined by GST Council. Then apart from that, GST Council will also decide the threshold limit of turnover below which GST is not applicable. So that threshold limit will also determined by this GST Council. So in India, we have a threshold limit. Okay, below which, if the turnover of a particular firm or a corporation is below that threshold limit, then that company or firm shall not be a part of GST, or GST is not mandatory on that particular firm or company. So that threshold limit will be decided by GST Council. Apart from that, GST Council will also decide the flow rate of the GST. For example, we have 5% GST, 12% GST, 18% GST, 28% GST. Who has decided that slab rate under GST? That is GST Council. Okay. Then apart from that, any special rate or rate for a specific period to raise additional resources during any natural calamities or disaster, that will also decided by the GST Council. In short, whenever we have any natural calamities or disaster, at that time government need funds. So tax is also one of the major source of fund to the government. So during natural calamities, whether an additional GST can be imposed on particular goods and services, okay, that will be determined by this GST Council. Then GST Council is also determine any special provision which can be given to the Himalayan state or special status state, like we have Uttarakhand, Himachal Pradesh, Sikkim and Seven Sisters. So for those states, any special provision, that special provision will be determined by this GST Council. Okay, apart from that, any matter which is related to the goods and service, that will also determine by this GST Council. So these are the function of GST Council, and GST Council, it is a constitutional body and it has a chairman who is Union Finance Minister. So that is about GST Council. Then what are the taxes from central government and state government which were subsumed under GST? So from central government, central excise duty, now we don't have these taxes. All these taxes were subsumed under GST. So from central government, central excise duty has been deleted, now it is a part of GST. Duty of excise, medical and toilet preparation, this tax is also subsumed under GST. Additional duty on excise, additional duty on excise textiles and textile products, additional duty on customs, popularly it is known as CVD, additional duty of custom, this also subsumed under GST. Then special additional duty on custom, this is also subsumed under GST. Service tax, as I already discussed, Article 268 was repealed or deleted by 101 Constitutional Amendment Act. So even service tax is also a part of GST. It means now we don't have any service tax. All these taxes are subsumed. So any central surcharge or cess, so far the central government levied on goods and services, those were also a part of GST now from central government. From state government, state VAT, state sales tax, luxury tax, entry tax, entertainment and amusement tax. Okay, entertainment and amusement tax, like we have amusement park, entertainment theaters. So the tax on those entertainment and amusement parks, earlier it was levied by the state government as well as the local government. So the tax which were levied by the local government, it is out of GST, and the tax which were levied by the state government, now it is subsumed under GST. Then apart from that, tax on advertisement, purchase tax, tax on lottery, betting and gambling. Then apart from that, all other state surcharge and cess, so far state government levied on particular goods and services, those are also a part of GST now. So these are the taxes which were subsumed under GST. So these are the taxes of central government which were subsumed under GST, and those are the taxes of state government which were subsumed under GST. So there are certain goods and services which are exempted from GST. At present, custom duty is imposing by central government along with IGST on imported duty. So that is one exemption. Apart from that, petrol and petroleum products, tobacco and tobacco products are also exempted from GST. Apart from that, excise duty on liquor, excise duty on stamp paper, stamp duty and electricity tax. So these are also at present exempted from GST. So this is all about 101 Constitutional Amendment Act, that is GST, Goods and Service Tax. So please do like and share our video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and don't forget to press bell icon for more updates. Thank you.